Myself, Satish Goda, Assistant Professor of Zoology, Government First Year College of Arts, Science and Commerce, Shirak. In this session, I am going to speak about a topic, Economic Importance of Fishery, for Tumkur University, 3rd BSc, 6th Semester Zoology, Paper 7, Applied Zoology. As we all know that fisheries are also having their own importance like other sectors like sericulture, poultry, dairy, like all these, even though fisheries also have their own importance, and these fisheries has become subsidiary source of income for the farmers and other fishermen and the people who are culturing the fishes in fisheries. These fishes and fisheries, which gives some byproducts of marine and inland fishery, the byproducts of marine and inland fishery, which have a great importance to humankind or a mankind. So we will discuss one by one. The first one, fishes as a human food. The majority of the fishes serve as a source of food to mankind. The flesh of fish contains 22 grams of protein, 9 grams of fat. The fish flesh is easily digestible and contains important vitamins like vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin D, vitamin B12, and an important omega-3 fatty acids, which are heart friendly. So this omega-3 fatty acids are very good, heart friendly. Hence the fishes, we are using this fishes as a food. So as a food, fishes have their own importance, economic importance, and useful to the mankind. The fish flesh also contains minerals like iodine, phosphorus and calcium, etc. And important fishes, food fishes, so we can call classify it as freshwater food fishes and marine water food fishes. So freshwater food fishes are Catla, Labio rohita, Labio calabasu, Labio bata, Clarias, Maitius, then Wompak, Bimatulates, etc., etc. So these are all freshwater food fishes. Then the following are the examples of marine water food fishes. Marine water food fishes. So they are shark, sardine, markhel, isha ilsha, Bombay duck, silver bellies, pompet, ribbon fishes, etc. All these are marine water food fishes and some of the freshwater food fishes. There are many food fishes are available in the nature and in the aquatic ecosystem. And second important economic importance of fisheries is the fishes are used as an ornamental purpose or decorative purposes. So here we are using these fishes, which are used to decorative home aquarium, are called as ornamental fishes. The ornamental fishes have aesthetic value. Following some of the fishes which are used to decorative home aquarium, they are goldfish, guppy, molly, fighter fish, comet, sucker catfish, shark, angel fish and paradise, etc. These are the some of the ornamental fishes which are using in our home decorative as a home aquarium. Coming to the third economic importance of fishery, that is medicinal value. Medicinal values of fishes. So here the medicinal fishes, the fish considered as a healthy food. It is included in the diet of people who require protein diet. Fish is also used to cure illness like asthma. Fish is also used in the preparation of Ayurvedic and Yunani medicine. Fatty fishes such as salmon, mackerel, and sardine provide EPA, eicosapentaenoic acid, EPA. So the EPA reduces, eicosapentaenoic acid reduces the level of cholesterol in the blood. Fish is also recommended for the cure of night blindness and neck goiter. So hence these fishes are used as a medicinal fishes, and it has fisheries has their own medicinal values. This is one more economic importance of fishery. And coming to the next one, the fishes are used as a body oil. The oil which is extracted from the whole body fishes is called body oil. The body oil is extracted from fishes like salmon, sardine, and herrings, etc. So these are the some of the fishes which are used for the extracting body oil. And this body oil is used in tanning industry to process leather. And the body oil of these fishes are used in manufacture of paints and also used in the manufacture of low grade soap. And body oil of fishes also used in the manufacture of printing ink and also used in the cosmetic industry. These are the some of the importance of body oil of fishes, and hence body oil of fish has its own economic importance in the fishery. And next one is fish meal. Fish meal is a byproduct of fishing industry. After oil extraction, the remainings of the fishes are made into the powder and dried. This powder is called fish meal, which is rich in proteins and minerals like calcium, phosphorus, iodine. And this fish meal is used as poultry and cattle feed. So here that fishes are powdered and dried. After powdered and dried, so this powdered meat is used as a food for the poultry and cattle feed. Next one is the fish floor. The flesh of shark and sardine are washed, boiled, deodorized, heat dried and powdered. Then this powder is called as flesh floor, which is rich in protein. This fish floor has very much protein rich content, which is used for the food purpose. And next one is ornamental scale. So the scales of fishes like garpike and lepidosteus used in jewelry, the scales of alpha used in manufacture of artificial pearl. So hence the scales are used in the ornamental tools, preparation of ornamental articles. And the next economic importance is fish glue. Fish glue, it is a gelatinous substance prepared by boiling waste such as bone, skin and fins of fishes. Glue is used as a adhesive for book binding, labels and paper boxes, etc. So see here, these skin, fin and fins and bones of fishes are used to prepare the gummy material, fish, that is fish glue. Next one is fish skin. The skin of fishes, large fishes, subjected to the process called tanning to obtain leather. The leather is used in the manufacture of shoes, bags, belts, purses, etc. So all these ornaments and other ornaments are prepared, articles, bags, shoes, belts, purses, etc. All these articles are prepared, or things prepared by the fish skin. Hence, this fish skin has its own economic importance. And the fish soap, next one is fish soap. Fish soup. So, the fins of various sharks are dried and exported to other countries. The dried fins of sharks are generally used to prepare the fish soup, like tomato soup and other soups. So they are used in fish powder, shark powder and other fish powders used to prepare the fish soups. Then the mosquito fishes are biological control fishes. So here the fishes which feed on the larvae of mosquitoes are called as larvivorous fishes. Means there are some fishes which feed on larval forms of the mosquitoes. Hence, these fishes are called as larvivorous fishes. So, these fishes are Gambusia, Barbus and Dania, etc. These fishes act as agents of biological control of mosquito. Hence, these are known as mosquito fishes or biological control fishes. And the next one is fish insulin. See here, the fishes are also used to prepare the insulin. Means the pancreas of the fish, large fishes, are removed and used for the manufacture of artificial insulin. And this is how the fishes has their own importance. And coming to the next economic importance, that is scientific value. Some fishes like scolodon, perch, crabs are used as a dissection specimens in the laboratories and laboratories of the various colleges, schools and institutions to know the various systems of the body. Thus, these fishes have the scientific value. So, there are some fishes like scolodon, perch, crabs, etc. These fishes are used for the purpose of study to know the various systems of the body. Thus, these fishes are considered and which have their own scientific value. then the next one, shark green. Skin of shark provided with microscopic placard scales. The dried processed skin of shark is called as shark green, which is used by carpenters to polish wooden articles. Carpenters are used to polish the wooden articles. These polishing wooden articles, to polish the wooden articles are made by shark green, means skin of shark, and also used these placard scales of fishes are to prepare the shark green or polishing material. And these are the some of there are about 16 economic importance, and still there are many economic importance, and these are the few important economic importance of fishes. So I will stop here. I'll meet you in the next session with the next topic. Thank you very much.